Conversations with our customers. Over 900,000 of them. That's why we know our customers prefer car insurance they can rely on. And at NFU Mutual, we pay out on 98% of claims. We understand customers. And unlike some others, we don't charge admin fees for making changes to your policy. And with NFU Mutual, your no-claims discount is protected if you're hit by an uninsured driver. Oh, and we include RAC breakdown cover as standard too. These are some of the reasons we are a Which? Recommended car insurance provider. If you'd like to have a real conversation about quality car insurance, call our UK team today or visit nfumutual.co.uk to find your local agent.
Are you with me?
Whatever it takes to support people living with cancer in a time when they need us most. Sign up today
to get your free fundraising kit by searching Glenn Coffee Morning.
Why prevent people from taking the Zoom Zoom at Sky Sports Box Office? Take a look at channel 491 or go to skysports.com/why.
Thought it would be nice to come for a drink here with Dad.
Oh, is he coming down?
Sort of. Bringing you on in.
Oh, God, I'm so, so sorry.
There are some things that CVs don't tell you. Pick who you work with carefully. Killer Colleagues is tonight at 10. Never giving up without a fight. Determined to keep you entertained. Royal London sponsors Pick.
Stamps are fake.
Is he a security threat?
I'm a fake. Crushes.
Welcome to Australia.
These people who very terrible. We're in love with
them. To me, he looks nervous.
And tough questions for a drug suspect.
Why did you change your flight? Just staying here for 2 days doesn't make sense at all.
It's 6 a.m. Rush hour at immigration. For thousands of passengers, the warm welcome makes the long haul all worthwhile. But it's not for everybody. In a locked immigration office, Emmanuel is having an anxious wait.
I've been looking for the past 2 days. Where? You know I have to wait here on chair.
This gentleman has arrived on an Italian passport. Speaking to him, our officer realised that he's not a native Italian speaker. The question is now, what is his nationality?
My first job would be able to tell me whatever's going to happen.
I have a number of concerns about this passport. The first one is if we have some stamps in his passport that indicate he entered and left Melbourne Airport in 1999.
We have no record of that on our systems, which sets alarm bells ringing. And look,